Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the businesses of San Marcos and citizens of San Marcos and North County Innovate 78, San Diego Corridor and beyond, on behalf of the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce, our board of directors, our business members, our volunteers, and the chamber staff, I welcome you. I am Pam Roemer, President and CEO of the San Marcos Chamber, and I have the distinct privilege to stand before you today in this awesome university and this awesome venue to represent the San Marcos Chamber. For those of you who may remember, and for those of you who do not, it was on July 11th, 1967, that the Chamber of Commerce was chartered. So this makes this our 48th year. As of July 11th this year, we will be year number 49, which makes next year in the summer, 2017, our 50th anniversary. I would like to say thank you to this group because just like the original charter members who came together to represent business and citizens in the San Marcos community to form the Chamber of Commerce, it is you, the interested citizens and businesses of San Marcos, who make the organization for the, both the city and the chamber what it is today. It's especially auspicious to be representing your community at this time and to be in partnership with the City of San Marcos and the Chamber and have the opportunity to stand here. Each of you looks absolutely awesome. Those of you that I spoke with before the event, I thank you so much. I thank you for attending and for supporting the organization. And at this time, as you finish greeting your table mates and making sure that everybody at your table is comfortable, I would like to say that Lila Hankins, who is, I'm really proud to announce, is our 2016 board chairperson for the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce will kick off the today's events for you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Pam. What an awesome CEO. Thank you so much for welcoming us and getting us started. Good afternoon. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the 2016 San Marcos, California State of the City Address and Chamber Installation and Awards. I'm Lila Hankins, chair for the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce and a full-time realtor with RE/MAX United. I'm proud to say my husband, Steve Hall, and I have been here in San Marcos as homeowners for 15 years, and we love this community. Would you please join me and stand and rise for the Pledge of Allegiance? Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. On behalf of the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce, with support from the City of San Marcos and generous event sponsors, who we'll recognize in a moment, I'd like to recognize the elected officials who have joined us today. From our own city of San Marcos, we have Mayor Jim Desmond. Vice Mayor Rebecca Jones. Council Member Chris Orlando. Council Member Krystal Jabara. Council Member Sharon Jenkins. From our neighboring cities, we have Carlsbad Mayor Matt Hall. Escondido Mayor Sam Abed. From the San Marcos Unified School District Board of Trustees, we have President Janet McLean. Vice President Pam Lindemood. Stacy Carlson. Randy Walton. Jay Patrick. And Superintendent Kevin Holtz. From Palomar's Governing Board, please welcome Nancy Chadwick. From Vallecito's Water District's Governing Board, we have Director Mike Sinella. And Director Hal Martin. And finally, representing Congressman Duncan Hunter, we have Don Burgett. Representing Senator Joel Anderson, Heather Garcia. Representing Assemblymember Marie Waldron, we have Marie Joyce and Tom Stenson. Jesse Navarro, representing San Diego District Attorney Bonnie Dumanis. Representing Supervisor Bill Horn, we have Haley Peterson. Thank you all for being with us here today. This event would not be possible without our incredible sponsors. First and foremost, I'd like to recognize our Diamond sponsors and our host venue sponsors. Cal State San Marcos is a Diamond sponsor who graciously agreed to host this year's beautiful event. Cal State San Marcos. Our incredible food is provided by Coast Catering and Chef Barry Lane and his amazing team. Thank you. We appreciate Tri-City Hospital for their continued partnership through their generous support that we've been able to make this happen today. So a round for Tri-City Hospital and our Diamond sponsors. Our very generous platinum sponsors. A sincere thanks to Cox Communications, Palomar College, San Diego Gas and Electric. Also, our appreciation to DR Horton, who provided our beautiful programs and event signs today. And to Stone Brewing for their generous sponsorship of the awards that you'll see later this afternoon. We're lucky enough to have even more sponsors. Our gold sponsors are our Children's Primary Dental Group. Thank you very much. North City. Thank you. And North County Health Services. Thank you very much. On behalf of the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce, we greatly thank all of you for your generous support. Let's give our sponsors one last round of applause. Well, I know you're really more interested in eating than hearing me. So after lunch is served, Vice Mayor Rebecca Jones will be back to kickstart the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce of Awards. So please take a few minutes, enjoy your lunch, and we'll be back up shortly.
Good afternoon. I'm Vice Mayor Rebecca Jones, and I'm excited to be here at this event today. Okay, now I'm feeling a little self-conscious. Okay, now everyone's quiet. Thank you so much. It's such a pleasure to be here today to celebrate our businesses in San Marcos. I would like to invite to join me up on the stage Mayor Jim Desmond and Council Members Chris Orlando, Krystal Jabara, and Sharon Jenkins. We're going to be giving out today's awards. It's such an honor to introduce to you the Chamber's Volunteer of the Year Award. Chamber volunteers, maybe you don't know what they do, but they are a team of chamber members that really take in the new members and teach them all about the committees, the programs, and all the different things that the chambers do, and also their events. So the Volunteer of the Year Award is given annually to the ambassador that is the most dedicated and spends the most time supporting the chamber events and programs. For the second year in a row, I am proud to announce that the Volunteer of the Year is Kathleen Quinn. Since becoming a chamber member, volunteer, Kathleen has been very active in helping out wherever she can. She has gone far above and beyond of all the things that a volunteer should do. And the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce has really gotten so much out of her enthusiasm, and she's such an example to all the future chamber volunteers. So come on up and get your award, Kathleen. I couldn't see you. I kept looking for you. So this is for you.
Oh,
it's beautiful.
Thank you so much. It is.
And if we could just come right over here and, oh, okay.
Well, let's go.
Right here. I don't know. I was thinking. Right
here. Come on in here.
You got my back.
Yeah. Yes.
All right.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Second year in a row.
Yeah, I didn't even know this time.
Oh, so glad. If you've ever gone to chamber events, Kathleen's always there. We are so blessed to have so many great businesses in the city that care about the community, and the caliber of nominees is so high, it's made it difficult to pick just one winner today. So each city council member will give a special plaque of appreciation to the nominated businesses that will fall into three categories: small, medium, and large businesses. I'll turn it over to council member Sharon Jenkins today, and she can give out the first category. Thank you, Sharon.
Thank you, Rebecca. It's an honor to be here today to recognize a special group, our outstanding small businesses that have 1 to 5 employees. It's our small, one-of-a-kind businesses that are the backbone to the entrepreneurial spirit that San Marcos is known for. Nominated by other chamber members, these small business nominees have demonstrated growth by overcoming challenges and exceeding the needs of their customers, all while having a positive impact on the business community. Will the representative from each of these nominated businesses please join me at the front of the stage as I call your name? Let's give a warm round of applause to 1850 Realty, A Frame of Art, Pro Quality Contracting, Two Men in a Truck, and Urbach Roofing.
Yeah.
congratulations to all of the small businesses. Now I'd like to welcome Councilmember Krystal Jabara.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today I have the privilege of honoring our medium-sized businesses. These are thriving businesses that employ 6 to 50 people within our community. And I've been told, according to the National Center for the Middle Market, mid-sized companies account for more than one-third of the private sector jobs, which is good for all of our communities and the economy, and they are the category that can withstand the ups and downs of the economy that we've most recently gone through. I'd like to say that this group of businesses is making the strongest impact within our communities. They are larger than our small size businesses, obviously, and they've been able to weather most of the changes in the economy, and I think a lot of people in here are medium-sized business owners or work for medium businesses, and I think that's because it's more of a family atmosphere. There's more loyalty, employer to employee, and I think they truly make a difference in our communities. They're involved in communities groups, and they do a lot with our sporting and our young people, so we'd like to thank all of our medium-sized businesses that are here today. We have 4 of them that we'd like to honor. The first one is Action Air Conditioning, Heating, and Solar. We'd also like to honor the Bellows. I don't think anyone goes to the Bellows. Cart Mart, who's been in San Marcos for a very long time. And one of our newer businesses that we're very pleased to have here, St. Catherine's College. Congratulations, everyone. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Should I not photobomb?
I think you should photobomb. Congratulations. Congratulations to our medium-sized businesses. And with that, I'd like to bring up Councilman Chris Orlando.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to be here, and it's also my honor to recognize the large businesses of the year. This group of businesses has an impact not only for the numbers of employees they have, but also for the amount of activity they do in our community from an economic standpoint, from their employees being volunteers and contributing to the community, from their customers and their patrons being a part of our community. So these large businesses, we all know them. They're all active, and we may be having lunch in one of their facilities today, not to let you on to who it is. But these are the types of businesses that are the anchors to our local economy and the anchors to our community. So it's my honor to recognize the large business honorees of the year. First, Cal State University San Marcos. Next, My favorite happy hour and restaurant, Elephant Bar and Restaurant. And finally, Silvergate, San Marcos. Thank you to all the large business nominees for the tremendous role you play in our community. And it's my pleasure to welcome Mayor Desmond, who will honor the business of the year.
All right, thank you very much.
All right, how's lunch? Good. Started dessert yet? Yeah, okay, good. Well, anyway, it's a pleasure and an honor to be here today to tell you this year's business of the year in the city of San Marcos. As you heard, all businesses that have come up here and have gotten awards, everybody does a great job in the city of San Marcos, and we're very proud of all of our businesses and all of the folks that are part of the great economy that we have here in the city of San Marcos. So I'd like to announce that the business of the year, can I have a drum roll? All right. Goes to Cartmart. Cartmart, Business of the Year in San Marcos, 2016. Where's Brian? Come on back up, Brian. All right, Business of the Year. Hey, congratulations. Yeah, you're welcome. Congratulations. Well, thank you.
This is great.
All right, here you go through the gauntlet here. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry. Another big hand for Cartmart, Brian Rott from Cartmart. Okay, next, we are going to keep moving here. We've got the chamber installation. We got our board members. It's my privilege to actually install our 2016 chamber board. Before getting started, though, I want to thank our retiring board members. So if you could please stand as I call your name for our retiring board members. Tim Williams. Where's Tim? Tim has done an awesome job over at Markstein Brewery or Markstein Distributors, and has put a lot of time and effort into the Chamber of Commerce, and we really appreciate his work. Marie Purdy, where's Marie? Is Marie here? Oh, there she is in the back. There's Marie. Marie always does a fantastic job. She shows up at all the sundowners. She takes your money as soon as you walk in there. So we appreciate your efforts, Marie. You've been a pillar there at the city at the Chamber of Commerce. So we thank you. And Paul Van Middlesworth. Is Paul Van Middlesworth here today? Where's Paul? Well, he's not here. I don't see Paul. Paul is from the computer factory. Paul has also been an institution. He and his wife, Noam, done a great job for the Chamber of Commerce and here in San Marcos, and so we want to thank them as well. And someone who could not join us today, if you remember who she was, it's Lydia Romero. You remember Lydia? Lydia Romero. I don't know if everybody knows or not, but Lydia Romero is actually our former deputy city manager. She has moved on. She is now, hopefully I get this right. Thank you. She's now the city manager at Lemon Grove, so she moved up, so it's great for her to do that. So now, will the new and returning board members please join me, and I guess line up here in front of the stage. We've got quite a few if you're here today. We have Leela Hankins, come on up. Here, well, we got a list here. Hold your applause. We'll get them all up. Leo Hankins, Matt Simmons, Dan Reichel, Don Cole, James Testa, come on up front here. Laura Gropin from Palomar College. Linda Bailey from Community Strategies Group. Margie Fugate from Casino del Charro. Pam Wells from Cal State University San Marcos. Tess Radmill from the city of San Marcos. Todd Carnig from Stone Brewery. And Vicki Betts from Edco. Come on up, everyone. All right, folks, let's give them all a hand. This is the San Marcos Chamber Board for 2016. Okay, now what we're going to do is I'm going to swear in for the oath here for the new board. So I want you to all raise your right hand and repeat after me. Not the audience, you don't have to do it, but okay. In the presence of those assembled here today, I do solemnly promise and pledge that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. You got it. Okay. And that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon which I am about to enter. All right, congratulations to our new and returning 2016 board members. Yes, you may. Okay, have a seat. Okay, we're going to take a short break, and then so you can continue networking, eating your dessert, and enjoying the delicious meal by Coast Catering. Thank you very much. All right.
It's my distinct pleasure to introduce, to kick off this afternoon and introduce our mayor, Jim Desmond. Serving his 10th year as the mayor of San Marcos, Mayor Desmond has been a resident of San Marcos since 1992. And he's been married with his beautiful wife, Carrie Desmond, for 32 years. Yes, 32. And they have two beautiful grown children, and they reside in Twin Oaks Valley. He has always been an active member of the community since he started out serving as the first PTO president at Twin Oaks Valley Elementary. Mayor Desmond also served on the San Marcos Economic Development Corporation, and he was a member of the city's planning commission, a San Marcos Chamber Board member, all the while he was active with the San Marcos Kiwanis Club and the Boy Scouts of America. In his role as mayor, Mayor Desmond is also San Marcos's representative for San Diego Association of Governments, and he serves as the chair of the City of San Marcos Fire Protection District Board of Directors. It's quite a mouthful. And he's also the alternate representative for North County Transit District. When he's not tending to city business, he's also called Mayor Desmond while he flies Captain Desmond, apologize for that, Captain, in his day job at Delta Airlines, flying 757s and 767s. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our mayor, Jim Desmond. You're welcome.
All right.
Well, good afternoon, San Marcos. All right. It is a pleasure and an honor to be here before you today. And I want to thank everybody for coming to support the City of San Marcos, the San Marcos Chamber of Commerce, and Cal State University San Marcos. Is this a great venue or what? Yes. We have been trying for years to get the State of the City address here. If you remember, we started it out about 7 or 8 years ago. We started at City Hall, and then we moved to different venues, and now we got this beautiful one here. Unfortunately, we've got the shades down so because of the TVs and everything else, but we appreciate you all coming out here today. Again, I want to acknowledge some of my fellow mayors from the other cities along the 78 corridor. We got Matt Hall here today. We got Mayor Sam Abed. Yes, give him a hand. And I also want to thank all of our city staff that's here today. How about our city staff stand up and be acknowledged? There they are. Oh, boy. All right, they're all at one table, folks. So if you're looking for your permit or you're looking for something else, they're all over here. Unfortunately, Jack Griffin, our city manager, couldn't be here today. He's having to attend to a family member. So our prayers and thoughts go out to Jack's family today. So he couldn't make it. But also our citizen volunteers that are here today. All our citizen volunteers, different commissioners, all the folks that have a great impact on our city. How about they stand up also? Our citizen volunteers. I know they're out there. There we got one. There's, all right, Jay Sogo. Thank you very much for coming today. So, you know, I try to get down in a nutshell. So what is San Marcos? So San Marcos, actually, we are a diverse and thriving community. We're built upon partnerships on a very strong foundation of businesses and high-quality education. That's kind of San Marcos in a nutshell. We're very proud to be the North County's education hub here at the city of San Marcos and a business and be a thriving business community as well. Some of the partnerships that we've shared recently with the Vallecetus Water District. I see our Water District folks are here. We have a couple board members are here today. We've had joint meetings with the VWD in the last couple of years, trying to work through the drought, which we're still not over yet with the drought here in Southern or in California. We got a lot of snowpack here recently, but we're still not out of it. But we joined with them and had joint board meetings to where we try to figure out solutions for resources for water and how the city, how we could set a better example throughout the drought here. Also want to thank for our partnerships with our awesome, award-winning, real estate price rising educational institutions here in San Marcos. We've got San Marcos Unified School District. We got the board is here, I think. Where's the board members? They're all in the back. Yeah. It's a great job. We always try to take credit for their great school scores, but we can't really do that, but it makes San Marcos a better place. San Marcos Unified School District, we also have Palomar College. Where's Palomar College? You're here? Yay, Palomar College. And of course, Cal State San Marcos with this beautiful venue here today. Yay. St. Augustine and St. Catherine's University, also here in the city of San Marcos. Where are they? I know Dr. Frank was here in the back. And we've got many, many other high-quality, high-scoring charter schools here in the city of San Marcos. So we are the education hub of North County, and we are creating the talent and attracting the businesses here that really make us strong and make San Marcos stand out, and we are very, very proud of it. So applause. Sign? Okay. So personally, myself and the rest of the city council members, the way we try to go about achieving goals and getting things done here in the city of San Marcos, there are three guiding principles that we use. And I got to tell you, they're the exact same three I use when I'm flying airplanes across the country, or across the planet. And those are safety is number one. Always safety is number one. We've got, oh, great pictures. Safety is number one. And also, number two is management of resources. And number three is quality of life. So safety in an airplane, I just got back in from Tokyo last night. Staff was a little bit nervous about me getting back that late. I was on break. I was actually emailing city staff. They're saying, are you going to make it tomorrow? Are you going to be here? I was just south of Russia coming over from Tokyo. And amazingly, we have email now on the airplane. I was on break. I was not flying the airplane at the time. So I was able to make that happen. But safety is always number one. And whenever flying an airplane, you know, any decision you have to make, what's the safest decision I can possibly make? And if you have any doubt, go for error. Always err on the side of safety. And with the city, it's safety is number one. Safety of residents is number one. We want to make sure that our police and fire departments have the tools and the training and the support that they need to do the fantastic job that they do. So safety is always number one. Management of resources is the next one. And management of resources in the airplane, it's time, it's fuel, it's the crew, it's the aircraft systems, it's air traffic control, weather, airports, whole group of different things. In the city of San Marcos, it's the same. It's management of resources with taxes. It's with roads and infrastructure. It's with management of construction jobs. I got a list of it here. I want to make sure I get them a budget. Roads and parks. Land use is big. In the traffic. Traffic. Everybody loves our traffic. But anyway, the management of resources. And then in the quality of life. Now, quality of life is number three, but it's not necessarily there because of that. But if you get number one and number two right, safety and management of resources, then the quality of life will raise up. In an airplane, quality of life is the cabin pressure, the temperature in the cabin, lots of leg room, great food, everybody gets an armrest. We try to make, you know, to get out of the turbulence and things like that, changing altitudes, and always a smooth landing. For the city of San Marcos, for the quality of life, it's the parks and the parks and the trails and the community services and the senior programs that we have that all kind of bring it together. So, of those three guiding principles, safety, management of resources, and quality of life, I'm going to start out with safety. In 2015, our fire department had almost 10,000 calls. It's a 21% increase over last year. Who's calling all that time? Almost 10,000 calls to our fire department. So that's a pretty big increase. And last year, our fire department actually received a new fire rig, a brush fire rig that allowed, as many of you through the Cocos fire that we had a couple years ago, they did a fantastic job. So another brush fire rig is definitely welcome. Where's is Brett here today? No. They're out. I'm one of those 10,000 calls, probably. They're out there. But we want to acknowledge our firefighters for the fantastic job. We can give them a hand anyway. For the great job they did with the Cocos fire. Let's see. Right here at Cal State San Marcos, our sheriff's personnel and emergency personnel throughout North County, they all got together here. And unfortunately, they had to practice an active shooter drill right here on campus. And we're glad and happy that they did that. They also, last year, had a drill on a power outage, a countywide power outage, and it was testing our resources and our backup procedures there. Sacramento, though, in their infinite wisdom of overregulation and stealing local tax dollars, recently added letting criminals out of jail early to their list of accomplishments, which has actually caused a little bit more supervision time by our sheriff's department for the local criminal supervision. But in spite of that, in the last few years, Sandag has come out with a study that said crime over the last several years has decreased in San Marcos by 24%. So we're down quite a bit, yes. And that's all due to our sheriff's captain, Mike McLean. Mike, why don't you stand up? He looks like a movie star. He's really just tall and handsome and doing a great job, though. One of the other things that our sheriff's department is doing is they're doing, you know, we have neighborhood watches. Now, working with businesses, and hopefully most of the businesses are participating here, in a business watch. So similar to the neighborhood watch, but business watches as well, trying to keep their places safe and keep a lookout. Sheriff's department also in the last year, they met with over 1,000 students and parents doing a Start Smart program, which is to teach new drivers their responsibilities behind the wheel. You know, it's sort of the responsibility, sort of like, hey, you're at a stoplight, it turned green, please stop texting and go, will you? Get that out of the way. So that's my own in there. But San Marcos, the crime never really goes away. It's always going to be something that we have to manage and be after. And our San Marcos deputy sheriffs do a great job for us in keeping us safe. So we acknowledge that for them. Moving on to management of resources now. Once again, okay, the applause lights are going to go up soon. Once again, in 2015, we balanced the budget. Yes. And we stand firm as a council on always keeping strong reserves. But when I first took office, we had very strong reserves at that point in time. But we really didn't have a policy of what to do with that money. So recently, the city council, we came up with a kind of a simplified version of what do we do with reserves. And what we came up with is a third, a third, and a third. So a third of the dollars for reserves go to catastrophic events. So we got earthquakes, fire, flood, locust, tsunami, meteor, whatever hits us, we're ready for it with a third of the reserves. The other third goes for a shock absorber to our general fund. So if we get some unforeseen circumstance, some unforeseen dollar amount, something happened that we weren't quite ready for, we make sure that we have dollars available for that. Then the other third of the dollars, and this is kind of rings true for San Marcos and what we've done in the last several years or even before me, is San Marcos is very entrepreneurial. We'll go out and invest dollars in land or invest dollars in buildings and try to bring money back into the coffers of the city of San Marcos without going into your wallets. Yes, you should applause. So, recent example, I shouldn't have to tell you when to applause, but anyway. Recent examples of investment dollars is have been at three different places that you've seen come up. The DMV, Hobby Lobby, the DMV, Hobby Lobby, and also Winco Foods. Those three businesses actually sit on yours, on city property. The DMV is actually in a collaboration or partnership with Lusardi. But those three, and also they sit in city buildings as well. Those three businesses, Winco, Hobby Lobby, and the DMV. Out of those three businesses, they bring about $2 million a year in annual income to the city, and they employ about 250 San Marcos employees. So that's what we do with those reserve dollars, by those opportunity dollars, is try to make it so you don't have to pay as much in taxes. Yes, there we go. And along with that policy, one of the things that we came up with is actually we have to pay back those dollars within 5 years. So that investment needs that we reach into the reserves for has to be paid back, and it has to be back in a timely manner, and we have to have that financial plan, right, Laura, ahead of time in place before we go after those dollars. So I want to thank you very much for that. The city is always addressing our infrastructure, our streets, our roads, storm drains, everything else within the city. And in an effort to support that, what we did last year, in last year's budget, we took over $2 million off the top of the budget to go towards infrastructure. Because as we become more of a maintenance city, we need to have those dollars coming off the top. They used to come off the bottom if we had money left over. Now they're coming off the top. And that $2 million that we took last year, that's going to be increased by a certain percentage every year until we get to about $6 million. The city staff did a great, phenomenal job of doing an inventory of all the streets, the roads, the buildings, the firehouses, you know, everything that the city owns, and what's it going to take to maintain the roads. And so we have a steady state of maintainability for our infrastructure, and that was about 10% of the general fund. So what we've done is we've started that last year, and we're going to keep increasing that each year until we get to that 10%. So the future generations of San Marconians sitting here can have that, know that that infrastructure and those dollars are in place. So we're trying to think ahead. We're always trying to get things done ahead of time. And I got to tell you, it's similar to like flying an airplane. I'm thinking 500 miles ahead of that airplane all the time. We're doing 500 miles an hour. I'm always trying to think ahead. And we do the same thing here at the city of San Marcos. If you make small corrections now, you don't have to make huge ones later. And that's what we did with the reserve dollars. Property values remain constant. Lease revenue is stable. And the sales and property taxes are up just slightly. We have a new communications campaign called Engage San Marcos. Sarah McDonald, our information, our PR person at City Hall, has come up with that, and that's basically what we're trying to do is get citizens more engaged so that we have on our new city website and social media and things like that, we've got to report a concern. So if you see something out there, you can go to the city's website or go to the social media and report a concern. City staff will get on it. As long as it's not an emergency, if it's an emergency, call 911. But otherwise, go to here. If a tree is down or a sprinkler, you see a sprinkler spraying, you know, up 12 feet in the air and it's going nowhere, you know, let us know about it, because we want to get on those things right away. We're accepting job applications online now. We're also accepting permits online, permit applications. We're putting more and more government data and documents online as well. So I want to thank you once again. Where's that table of city staff? Stand up again. Yeah. Thank you so much. Come on. All right. All right, next year we got to split you guys up. You got to be moving around the table here. So, okay, so what are all the building that's going on in San Marcos? There's a lot of building going on here, and the city building department actually issued over 2,000 permits last year. 2,000 permits and did over 11,000 inspections. So they've been very busy. The Voice of San Diego, they named San Marcos North County's Smart Growth Champion. Now, yay, thank you very much. The Smart Growth Champion, they've called us other things in the past, but we're not going to bring those up. But as the Smart Growth Champion, primarily because we completed, or it was completed through Lyons, is Lyons Communities here? They completed the Palomar Station project across from Palomar College. It's 370 units at Palomar Station, housing units there. And right next to it, we've also approved Davia Village, which is 400 more housing units right next to Palomar Station. And that is actually making that area more of a transit-oriented development. It's right across from the Sprinter Station, across the street from the bus transit center, right next to the freeway interchange onto the 78 as well. And with a grant from SANDAG, it was a $2 million grant. What's connecting those two projects is Armor Light Drive. Remember Armor Light used to be here? It's all going to be apartments. But the Armor Light Drive, the $2 million grant is actually going to give us wider streets in there. The streets are going to have bike lanes, pedestrian crosswalks, wider sidewalks to try to make it more of a pedestrian-friendly, transit-oriented development there in across from Palomar College. You could see it earlier out the window here. Right down on Mission Avenue, there's also a project going on the side of the Mission Road. It's called Mission 316. I think that's the address. Integral Properties is actually developing that. It's by City Hall on Mission Avenue on the north side of City Hall. It's up on the side of a hill. You see a lot of construction vehicles and dust coming up from there a little bit. But that's going to be 92 townhomes that's coming to San Marcos soon. And again, that project is within walking distance of the Sprinter. Moving further down, there's major grading at Twin Oaks Valley Road and San Marcos Boulevard. We all see that mound of dirt. If I were in a Jeep, I'd drive. It's just so tempting, you know. I don't think my Buick will do it, but it's so tempting to see that huge mound of dirt. That's Mike McDonald and Gary Levitt's project over there. That's going to be a new Fairfield Inn and Suites Hotel right there on that corner. Yes, and retail is also going in, and possibly a little bit of residential in the back of that. But that's underway, and that's just, I don't know how they're, that's a huge amount of dirt if you've seen that thing. They have that there. But in North City also, another Mike McDonald and Gary Levitt, which is... Hopefully they'll open these shades here after the program. You can take a look out. But is North City, called North City. They're also one of our sponsors today. And at North City, it's where the quad is located, the student housing in the quad. They also have Block C coming along, which is a market rate apartments right behind the quad. That's in construction. I see there's a leasing sign already up. So hopefully that's going to open up soon. And right behind that's a new parking structure. And then adjacent to that, hopefully we're going to get some entertainment and opportunities in that area as well for the students and for people moving into that Block C. I don't know if that's out yet, what that is, but that's going to be coming soon. So earlier I was talking about Hobby Lobby and Winco Foods. How many people love that street light right next to Hobby Lobby? You got one option at that street light, and we got a whole street light. You pull up to it, and it's red, and it's like, oh my gosh, why is this thing here? But anyway, that street light actually hopefully is going to connect to a street in the Creek District. Hopefully you're going to be able to take a right instead of only a left to go into Hobby Lobby. That street, Creekside Drive, if you notice, we've got two projects that sprouted up in May of last year along the creek area. We've been waiting for that for years. Promenade at the creek, Promenade at Creekside, and also the Eastgate project. They're right next door to each other, and Creekside Drive should be connecting through from Grand Avenue, where that favorite lovely stoplight is, to nowhere, and then going to Bent Avenue. So you have another option coming out of that park, out of that shopping center. Yay, all right, yes. And we got, Hobby Lobby's in there. Have you been to the Hobby Lobby? Yes, very nice, very nice, yes. Hobby Lobby, go to Staples, go to Best Buy, go to the Crunch, go to, what else is in there? In-N-Out Burger, Phil's Barbecue, Applebee's, Winco, New York Pizza, Chick-fil-A, everything's in there. Come on. So hopefully we're going to make it easier to get in the Shell station. I get my car washed there. It's a great shopping center. We're just trying to get traffic flowing in and out of there a little bit more easily. Let's see. Oh, San Marcos. One of the things, for all the developers, I've been giving them plugs here, but we also take money from the developers. Ooh, the room goes quiet. Okay. And what we take dollars out of them for infrastructure projects around the city. And one of them is along the 78. We're one of the few cities that actually takes money for a state road from developers to improve the traffic conditions. And so we've collected enough money here for a while, in the past several years, to redo the Woodland Parkway interchange. Now, there's not much of an interchange there now. Yay, okay. How many of you done that little hook on ramp from Barham onto the 78? It's like Frogger going across there. You gotta cross two lanes before you get to the next intersection. Otherwise, you're getting off at Nordahl. So you got to take a couple. So we're redoing Woodland Parkway interchange. It's about a $26 million project. And what that's going to do is add an additional freeway lane east and west from Twin Oaks Valley, from the Twin Oaks intersection to Woodland Parkway intersection. We're also going to be widening Barham Street as part of that effort. And Barham's the main street out here, so that folks and students from Cal State University San Marcos will have another option other than Twin Oaks Valley Road to go out and get to the freeway. So if you can get to it, Barham, go out to the Woodland Park interchange. We're also going to be widening Woodland Parkway. Woodland Parkway, the road itself, in front of Albertson's there, as you're going underneath the tunnel, you're heading towards Barham. There's three lanes under there. I think that's going to be, 14 lanes under that bridge. Is that right? Yeah, okay, we got applause for 14 lanes under there. Unfortunately, I don't think it's going to be that many, but that little tunnel interchange is going to be changing. So it's going to take a few years. I'll probably be at the next year's State of the City, be talking about that again. But know that that's underway, and we're trying to alleviate some of the traffic. And this is kind of rare that a city actually pays for a state route interchange. So we're taking that effort and moving forward with it. Also in the Creek District, I've talked about this before, but hopefully 2017, next year, I'll be talking to you about the two bridges over the Creek District in the Creek area. I don't know if I'm in, look at that. They're keeping up with me. The bridges over Via Veracruz is going to be going over the creek from San Marcos Boulevard to Discovery, and also, and that's going to be a four-lane bridge with pedestrian crosswalks on either side. And then also Bent Avenue Bridge is going to be a two-lane bridge as well. So, and the state actually tried to take those dollars away from us a couple of months ago, and we were able to fight that and keep those dollars here in San Marcos. Those are federal dollars the state was trying to take, and we were able to get, I think, 95% of it, which was pretty darn good, and keep it here. But in part of that process is Discovery Street is going to be widened, and the interchange at Discovery Street, where my favorite pink house, which I'm not going to bring up again, used to be. We're going to do that, change that interchange and make that a more functioning interchange, and hopefully keeping traffic moving. So that's a lot of resources, a lot of things that one table over here has to manage and keep in track do all the. It's just a lot of work for city staff. And also, I've noticed the Eubanks family is here. They're going to be upgrading Restaurant Row. Yes. Vera is still cracking the whip, and she is moving forward with some enhancements, some new buildings, some new restaurants in Restaurant Row, paseos, and more outdoor dining, making it much more more attractive than it already is. And in conjunction with another project, I guess with the Sears building, they're going to have a paseo, a nice walkway going to the front entrance of the movie theater at Edwards. So it's great plans coming soon. So dinner and a movie is even getting better in the city of San Marcos. So quality of life, the other guiding principle that we use. We're always looking for ways to improve service from City Hall. We're always looking for ways to try to do that. And what we've done is we've introduced a scorecard now. We're trying to keep track of different ways we can improve, different ways to give service to our citizens. San Marcos Community Services, which is also our parks and recreation area, they had more than 915 youth sports teams to manage. 915 youth sports. Think of all the parents that you gotta try to please out of that many youth sports teams. And then the management of all the parks and trying to make sure there's enough fields available for different. And there's competing entities with soccer and baseball, and everybody should have more fields. And we're trying to get as many as we possibly can online and keep those, and also keep the grass growing and keep things very nice and clean in the parks. So they've had that many youth sports teams, and they brought over 55,000 visitors to the city of San Marcos, helping, going to our restaurants and our businesses and helping enhance that. We're going to be breaking ground soon, right behind the post office on Richmar Park, back there. Our city pools had the record attendance of 62,000 people coming to the pools. I think it was pretty warm last summer, so that's probably the reason we had so many people coming to the pools. The Senior Activity Center is under new leadership there, and we've had a huge increase in the participation of classes and programs at the Senior Center. On Trails Day, the community services folks actually reopened the ridge-lined and double-peak trails. They were actually destroyed in the 2014 fire, the Cocos fire, and they got those reopened and back up last year. And San Marcos is finalizing the new master parks program for more parks and trails and recreation and infrastructure for the next 20 years. So one other topic I want to hit on after we get safety, management of resources and quality of life. Another thing is what we've City Council has gone and brought forward is new economic development. We're trying to enhance the way we or create an even more business friendly San Marcos. So we hired an economic development director. Tess Radmill. Tess is here today. Raise your hand, Tess. Yay! Actually, stand up, Tess. Okay. This is the person. This is our. I can't spell it. Ombudsman. For it's going to be the link between the businesses and City Hall. So I know she's already had successes with Hollandia Dairy, and some other businesses as far as trying to get, you know, if you're feeling frustrated or something like that at City Hall and you need somebody to reach out to, Tess Radmill is the go-to person. She's going to be the link. So we try to keep things moving and if things aren't moving, we can explain why they're not moving and things like that, but trying to help in our business community even better through economic development. So thank you, Tess. Yay. And we've been gaining momentum with the Innovate 78 initiative between the five cities along the 78, Escondido, San Marcos, Vista, Carlsbad, and Oceanside. And we've still been collaborating between those five cities. We are now viewed, when Sandag comes and talks to us, we're viewed as a block now, as far as, you know, getting things done, trying to get money into North County, trying to bring money for roads and services up here. So, yes, thank you. In that effort, what it's really done at this point so far, we really don't have like we brought this business here or this shining star has happened because of it. But one of the best things, and I think is really worth the price of admission, being part of this coalition of the 78 corridor, is it's gotten the communication lines open. The mayors, we started collaborating a few years ago. We meet a couple times a month. It's also got our city managers. I think they've always been collaborating as a group, but now they're collaborating as a 78 corridor group. Our economic development staffs are all meeting with each other once or twice a month, coming up with new ideas and new plans. We found out actually through San Diego EDC that one of our major companies here in San Marcos was looking to move or looking for new space. We had to find it out through San Diego, and then it got routed through the Innovate 78 group and then back to our city so that we can try to help this business stay here. But not only our planning staffs are collaborating, our sheriffs and our fire police and sheriff's department along the corridor are collaborating. The superintendents are collaborating also of each of the five cities. And Cal State University San Marcos, I'm pretty sure the educational institutions were already working together, but Cal State University San Marcos, Palomar College, MiraCosta College, Universities of St. Augustine, St. Catharines, all the universities and educational institutions across the corridor have been collaborating. And what they're trying to do, they want to make provide the next workforce to find out from businesses, what is it you need? What's the talent that you're looking for? What is it you're going to need to be successful? And these educational institutions are focused on our 78 corridor. And I think that really brings a lot to the table and brings a lot of people talking together. There's definitely strength in numbers. There's strength in collaborating with each other along the corridor so that we can be not just great as a city, but great as a region. Let's see. Again, once I'm finishing up here, last page. This was 24 pages initially. I got it down to 12. But I do want to thank everybody for being here today, for being a part of this. Cal State San Marcos has a great, gorgeous view out here. Glad that everybody got to come in and at least be on the campus and it feels kind of fun. You feel younger walking onto a college campus, and then you look at the kids and you feel older. But the it's a phenomenal here. We want to thank Cal State University San Marcos. Karen Haynes couldn't be here today, our president. Yes, thanks, Cal State. For this gorgeous venue, we appreciate that. Unfortunately, just one little plug here for the Boys and Girls Club. I want to put that out. Yay, Boys and Girls Club. My wife couldn't be here today because she's. We won at an auction last time a great item from the Boys and Girls Club that she's actually using. Had to use it or lose it. And Ginger Hitsky, where's Ginger? She bid me up on this item. which was great, though. It went to a great cause, the Boys and Girls Club. So we always enjoy supporting the Boys and Girls Club. I see we also have Terry in the room here today. We got other institutions that always, you know, just make San Marcos a great place to be and a great spot in the region. So thank you all for coming. Thank you for being here, for being part of the success of the city of San Marcos. Thank you.
Thank you again all so much for coming. I would like to take this moment to recognize all who helped make this event happen today. First of all, I would like to recognize my own staff, which is Melanie Yamil, Director of Events, if you will please stand. Tiffany Guevara, who is the Office Manager for the Chamber, and Joy Buckles, who is the Director of Membership. And next, I want to give a special thanks to Sarah McDonald from the City of San Marcos, the Communications Director. She has been just absolutely tremendous and awesome in working with our team to make sure that we're up to speed and attending to all the details and so forth. I'd like to give a special thanks then to my Board of Directors, so much for your support in the past year and a half, and I really appreciate that. And finally, to our sponsors. Our diamond sponsors, again, are Cal State University San Marcos. I can't say enough good about their team, which was Ellen Hawthorne and Caitlin, who really helped us with the venue today. Coast Catering, which is Barry Lane, who provided the food, and he was just simply tremendous in all the details. Tri-City Medical Center, who is always awesome to support so many chamber events and city events and so forth. Platinum sponsors, Cox Communications, Palomar College, Laura Gropin's on our board, San Diego Gas and Electric, who is always wonderful to support so many chamber events all through the year. Our program sponsor was DR Horton, and if you will hold your hand up. So we have front row for all the other group, and then DR Horton. The award sponsor for your awards today was Stone Brewing, and I thank you so much for that. Our goal, and these are all the people that helped make this event possible, because without their support and helping us to put this together, it wouldn't have happened today. And the gold sponsors are Children's Primary Dental Group, North City, North County Health Services. Our silver sponsors are CCI Consultants Collaborative, Mark Stein Beverage and Distributing, Remax United. Our ruby sponsors are Casino del Charro and Edco. And then I'm going to read our table sponsors, our AT&T, Cart Mart, City of San Marcos, Coleridge Homes, Diamond Environmental, Fisher and Ritchie, Hitsky Development, Integral Properties, Newland Sierra, San Marcos Highlands, Stephen A. Bieri Company, Twin Oaks Valley Equestrian, and Venture Point. Yay for all you. And again, I want to thank you all so much for coming. And then lastly, I want to thank the mayor of San Marcos, Mayor Desmond, because he was the one that got the ball rolling to get this started last year, actually, to put us at this beautiful venue. So we have to thank him. And just thank every single one of you for coming and for your support all year long. We truly appreciate it. And I can't say enough good about all of you. Thank you.